When Galileo trained his homemade telescope on the night sky, it transformed from a black pool populated by a few thousand stars into a sparkling sea filled with 10 times that number. And today, with the help of bigger and better telescopes, we know that our home galaxy, the Milky Way, is an ocean of as many as 400 billion stars. However, telescopes can't help us peer into the watery oceans here on Earth. So to count their inhabitants, we've used fish trawls to drag them up into the light, and then, more often than not, onto our plates. But now we don't have to fish in order to count fish. In 2010, Spanish researchers sailed around the world with an ultra-high-powered sonar, shooting sound waves into the depths and using the reflected signals to spot inhabitants. While previous net counts had given us a global estimate of about 300 trillion fish, the fishoscope method revealed that our oceans are home to roughly 10 times that number. One reason previous counts were so much lower seems to be that fish actively hide from approaching trawls. In one study, scientists took a sonar scan while dragging an open net through the water behind them. And check this out. So many fish got out of the way that their relative absence highlights the whole path of the trawl. We don't know exactly how they managed to avoid the nets, but deep ocean dwellers like the fangtooth, lanternfish, and stoplight loosejaw, all of which were especially undercounted by fish trawls, may take warning cues from their neighbors' flashing bioluminescent spots. Another deep water fish, the finger-sized bristlemouth, turns out to be the most populous vertebrate on our planet. There are an estimated quadrillion bristlemouths swimming the world's oceans. That's a few thousand fish for every star in the Milky Way. Hi, Emily here. I'd like to thank Audible.com for sponsoring this video. Audible has over 250,000 downloadable titles, including the epic Western novel Lonesome Dove by Larry McMurtry. Normally, I try to recommend a nonfiction science book because this is a nonfiction science YouTube channel. But I just finished listening to Lonesome Dove, and it's the kind of book where you get to like the characters so much you miss them when it's all over. And the narrator does an amazing job bringing them all to life, and basically, it would be wrong of me not to recommend it. To start listening to Lonesome Dove or any other audiobook of your choice, go to audible.com/MinuteEarth and sign up for a free 30-day trial. And as always, thanks for watching.